Here we can study about this structure into two parts. When we have three supports, we will use the superposition, principle of superposition, to solve this one. You will see, for example, if there are two supports A and B, and see it is like a cantilever. So if we apply the load like this, it will be behaving like a simply supported beam, and this will become straight, so there is no minimum there. Here only it is bending. There is no bending for this member BC, it is just a straight, so there is no effect of downward force for this simply supported. And in case the same beam, if I apply load here support, and here is a load is there, we are applying externally the load, so what will happen, it will come down, so it will maintain this slope, it will go like this, and like this it will come. Right, so there is a moment at B, so hogging moment, that's why it's coming like this. So here you can see the reaction VA VB, it's upwards, but because of this VC, suppose if this is not there, it will go like this, so it has to come down. So the reaction is coming at A is down, this up, this is the force. So if we remove the vertical reaction at C, that vertical reaction it is removed, then the beam becomes simply supported with the cantilever. If we now apply the reaction at C, if we apply reaction at C, we see as a load. Actually what we are doing, the reaction we are applying as a load. The combination of these two conditions will produce a solution to the original two span beam. Originally, if you consider the two span beam, AB and BC two span beam, if you combine these two, it will produce the same effect, that one. This is the example for the principle of superposition. This simple example illustrates one of the most powerful design tools in the armory of designer, since it allows the reduction of complex structure into simpler forms and the examination of load effects separately. For example, this that time it was a two span beam, it was a complex structure, so now we have replaced that as a simply support structure by removing one support. Like this we can make it reduce the structure, complex structures, into simple forms. Then because of this effect alone, force alone, what would be the impact? Like that we can study and we can examine the load effect separately. So the same way we can see the deflections also, we can treat the deflections also in the same way. Deflections may be also be treated in the same way. Here, for example, vertical deflection delta CV, because of this load W, if you apply load W, it will go upright. So this vertical deflection delta CV must be equal to the reaction down deflection due to the reaction force VC. If you apply the reaction force VC, it will have some downward displacement. These two displacements would be equal because originally at this point the deflection is zero. So this, like this, we can use the principle of superposition for the deflection cases also. Now let us see the same case. If I apply W here, what will happen? This point is a support point, so it will not move downward. This also, it will not move downward. So these two will be as it is here, it will be there. And load B point, that is exactly below the load, it will move downward. The load, the deflection, if you see, it may be more at the middle. The load point may be something different. If load and deflection point, if it is at the center, maybe sometimes it meets the maximum deflection on the load point, but here it's not the case. Even if you apply the load at here, the maximum displacement may be somewhere here. Okay, so this is the first example of qualitative analysis of structures simply supported with cantilever CD. The full solution of the qualitative analysis must always consist of, if you want to make a full solution, qualitative solution, you should always find out the three outputs like deflected shape, reactions, bending moments, and shear. Sometimes we can see it, but shear is not going to give that much intuitive idea about the analysis of beams, not like qualitative analysis of beams. Then let's go to the 10. Here we can draw a smooth curve connecting these three points. Here you can see CD remains straight. The curve must be smooth, and with practice very accurate deflected shape can be drawn, may be drawn. Try practicing the identification of the deflected shape with the flexible plastic ruler. Take one flexible plastic ruler and put support and apply the load. You can see how it deflects. And some portion deflects straight like this. There is no bending here because it's not bending. If you have some load here, then only it bends. Otherwise, it's a, because it's a roller, it maintains the slope at here and its slope at here same.